शुशिवर्णम चतुर्भुजम प्रसन्नवदनम ध्यायेत् सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये रामाय रामभद्राय रामचंद्राय वेधसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीतायाः पतये नमः पूजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरम् आरुह्य कविता शाखां वंदे वाल्मीकिकोकिलं अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरं जानकीशोकनाशनं कपीशमक्षहन्तारं वंदे लंकाभयंकरं नमोस्तु रामाय सलक्ष्मणाय देव्यै च तस्यै जनकात्मजायै नमोस्तु रुद्रेन्द्र यमानिलेभ्यो नमोस्तु चंद्रार्क मरुद्गणेभ्यः ओम नमः परमहंसास्वादित चरणकमल चिन्मकरंदाय भक्तजन मानस निवासाय श्रीरामचंद्राय ओम। सो वी आर इन, आई होप द ऑडियो इज क्लियर। वी आर इन अयोध्या कांडा फर्स्ट सर्ग। आई थिंक वी हैव सीन अप टू 27th श्लोक। श्रैष्ठ्यं चास्त्र समूहेषु प्राप्तो व्यामिश्रकेषु च अर्थधर्मौ च संगृह्य सुखतंत्रो न चालसः। आई थिंक वी हैव फिनिश्ड दैट श्लोक। सो सुखतंत्रः न चालसः, अर्थधर्मौ च संगृह्य सुखतंत्रः एंड न चालसः। देन वी हैव टू सी 28th श्लोक। वैहारिकाणां शिल्पानां विज्ञातार्थ विभागवित् आरोहे विनये चैव युक्तो वारणवाजिनां। सो वैहारिकाणां मीन्स क्रीडा प्रयोजनानां शिल्पानां गीतवाद्य चित्र कर्मादीनां विज्ञाता एंड अर्थविभागवित्। अर्थविभागवित् यू हैव टू टेक इट अस सेपरेटली एंड देन वैहारिकाणां शिल्पानां विज्ञाता, दैट इज वन। सो ही नोज वैहारिका, वैहारिकाणां विज्ञाता एंड शिल्पानां विज्ञाता। नो व्हाट इज दिस वैहारिकाणां विज्ञाता? क्रीडा प्रयोजनानां विज्ञाता, और वैहारिकाणां मीन्स विहार प्रयोजनानां विज्ञाता। सो ही नोज हाउ टू टेक एंटरटेनमेंट एटसेट्रा सच थिंग्स, हाउ टू एंगेज इन यू नो गुड एंटरटेनमेंट, सो दैट ही नोज, दैट इज वैहारिकाणां विज्ञाता। एंड देन शिल्पानां, शिल्पा जनरली इज अ एक्सप्रेशन फॉर एनी आर्ट फॉर्म इज शिल्पा। सो टुडे शिल्पशास्त्र व्हेन यू से इट हैज बीन रिड्यूस्ड टू स्कल्पचर, बट एनी काइंड ऑफ यू नो अ पेंटिंग एंड देन संगीता ऑल्सो आई थिंक। सो गीतवाद्य चित्रकर्मादीनां, या सो संगीतम and then even playing instruments, any kind of arts, they are generally referred to by Shilpa. So Shilpanam Vignata, so he is a connoisseur of arts also. I think this has come earlier also somewhere. So Vaiharikanam Vignata and Shilpanam cha Vignata, he is an expert in both of them. And then Arthavibhagavit, Arthavibhagavit means, so we have already seen Ayakarman Upayagnyaha Samhrishta Vyayakarmavit. So he knows how to collect taxes and how to do public spending, that we have seen. So here Arthavibhagavit means he knows how to divide wealth, that's the idea. So this also we will see later when Rama is leaving to Vanavasam, what he is doing with all his accumulated wealth, he just donates them. So this is Arthavibhagavit means he knows how to divide wealth and what to do with each portion. So Tikakaras will quote from, all of them have been quoting from one shloka from Bhagavatam, that I will tell you, but let us see the meaning. Then आरोहे विनये चैव युक्तः वारणवाजिनां। सो वारणवाजिनां, वारण मीन्स एलिफेंट एंड वाजी मीन्स हॉर्स। सो वारणवाजिनां आरोहे विनये चैव युक्तः, सो ही इज एन एक्सपर्ट इन काइंड ऑफ आरोहे मीन्स टू क्लाइंब एंड देन विनये मीन्स टू टेम। सो ही नोज हाउ टू काइंड ऑफ कंट्रोल एंड टेम एलिफेंट्स एटसेट्रा एंड देन हॉर्सेज एटसेट्रा, ही इज एन एक्सपर्ट। I think in one of these movies, Jodha Akbar or something, that's how the character of Akbar is introduced. So it's introduced like that. See, that is taken from Ramayana only, perhaps the idea. So Varana Vajinam Vinaye Yuktaha. So he's an expert in taming wild elephants also. And then after taming, what will you do? You take a ride on it. So something like that. Rama is an expert in such things also. Because in Yuddha, they will use, you know, so Ashwa and Gaja are part of the military, what should I say, paraphernalia those days. So these things you should know how to put a control to Varana and Vaji. So Rama is an expert in those things. So Vaiharikanam, Tilakakara read already, Krida Prayojananam and Shilpanam means Gita Vadya Chitrakarmadinam. So Gita Vadya and Chitrakarma is painting, etc. So in all such things he is Vignata, he's an expert. And then of those things he's an expert. And then Arthavibhagavit, Arthavibhagavit, they are quoting, this is a famous shloka from Bhagavatam, it comes part of Shukra Niti. So perhaps that is why Rama didn't follow it that way. Arthavibhagavit, you see, how he Shukracharya there for Bali he does an upadesha. You know the story. Vamana comes, Vishnu comes as Vamana in front of Bali, and Vamana has already given his word that I will give you what you are asking for. He asks for three steps, and then Shukracharya after that he comes. So he says, you have given some word, he has asked for something, forget all that, you take back your word. And then he will give some niti, some kind of, you know, so this is coming in Bhagavatam Ashtama Skandha 19th Adhyaya. So there the last 10-12 shlokas are filled with Shukracharya's, you know, niti vakya. So that Shukra niti is where you can, so there all you can follow adharma, that is what he says. So famous situation is, so even today some kind of that what should I say, that adharma that he speaks of there. So in some sense that is still, you know, they say even in popular parlance that statement is there. That is when it comes to the so in Telugu they say, yeah, so vei abaddalaadaina oka pelli cheyachu. So if you can to get one girl married, you can say a thousand lies also. So it's kind of exaggeration. That is, it's difficult to get girls married those days. That was a situation. Today it doesn't seem to be like that. So to get a girl married, you can lie sometimes. That is one case. But then Shukracharya strictly what he says is, in the case of women, you can lie. Something like that he says. So he gives a list of neetis there. One of the neetis is, you should not completely kind of give away your wealth. He tells Bali, because Shukracharya knows that the person who has come is Vishnu. And he tells him also that Vishnu only has come. So he is Danavari. He is going to end you. So he asks for three steps, but he's going to take your entire, even your life itself is now going to be under his control. So you should not do that. Interestingly, there is a very famous Brihadaranyaka quote. So what is the quote? I said famous, I don't know. So, yeah. So, tametam vedanu vachanena brahmana vividishanti yajnena danena tapasa anashakena. So this one Shruti Vakya is used to show that the entire Veda's tatparyam is in Jnanam only. So Jnana Kanda anyway directly in Jnanam, and then Karma Kanda also, so Aradupakarakam it is called. So indirectly even the tatparya of Karma Kanda is not in Karma, it is in Jnanam only. It is to make you prepared for that. So Swamiji quotes his father, you know, when he used to teach, his father would give this example. I think I said this earlier also. So to make that child take a bitter medicine, the mother will promise some sweet. So the child will take the medicine and then the sweet will not be given. So it's not good for him in his state of health, you know. So that sweet, some piece of jaggery or something, she will just say, I'm going to give you this if you take the medicine. I'm going to give you this if you take the medicine. Then he will take the medicine and then she will keep that in the jar and keep the jar somewhere far away. Like that, Veda also promises you will get heaven if you do this karma, you will get heaven if you do this karma. So all that he will do, but heaven, whether he obtained or not, of course, Shruti is telling he's obtaining. But then more the point is to infuse vairagya eventually. So na karmana na prajaya dhanena yage naike amritatva manashuhu, to kind of bring in, drive in that point into you, Vedas are telling even karma. So there that Shruti statement means, so don't think I'm beating around the bush, I'm coming to the point. So the Shruti also says, so tam etam vedanu vachanena brahmana vividishanti, through the vedanu vachana, that is through the words in the Veda, take it that way, brahmanaha vividishanti, that is brahmanas, so they get, brahmana means, so people, so pariksha lokan karmachitaha brahmanaha nirvedamaya, their brahmanas definition is somebody who can develop a vairagya after examining this world. Okay, so one thing is very clear, for obtaining jnanam, there is no restriction on any ashrama, on any vyavastha. Shankara clearly says, jnane sarvesham adhikaraha is there. Only in Veda adhyayanam, they have kept some rules, you know, to learn the letter of the Veda, because that was a big pursuit those days. You have to study Veda, then it is a commitment, because there is no books and script also perhaps was not there. You have to commit to that pursuit. You have to retain it in your memory. So if everybody is indulging in that, then the economy might get collapsed. In that sense, they said, okay, some specified people, you indulge in that. That is, you study those Vedas, etc. But for acquiring jnanam, there is no restriction whatsoever. It is very clear. Everybody is eligible. So brahmana means a vipaschit there. That person who has seen this world and some vairagya he has got. So brahmanaha vividishanti. So those people who have got vairagya, they have this vividisha. So that icha to know that they have that vividisha is generated. How is that vividisha generated? Yajnena, danena, tapasa. So through yajnas and then through danam and through tapas, that is all otherwise mentioned in the Karmakanda. The result of all that is vividisha, that's the meaning of that Brihadaranyaka Shruti. But very nicely Shruti also says there anashakena. So that type of yajna, that type of danam, that type of yajnena danena tapasa, by that type of tapas which does not destroy you, anashakena means, so it does not cause your nasha. Such kind of yajna, dana and tapas should be there. That is, you should not, so even Krishna says, you know, yuktahara viharasya, so yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta suptava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha. So you should have everything in you should avoid the extremes. So you should have yuktahara vihara and then yukta cheshtasya karmasu and then yukta suptava bodha. All should be in measure. You should not go to the extremes in either direction. You should not go to extremes. That is the meaning of anashakena there. So danam, anashakena danena, that is what I am trying to harp on, which is exactly what Shukracharya is telling, you know. So that anashakena danena, what Shruti is telling, perhaps that is why he is also telling that you should not do sarvasva danam when you are doing. So it should not be in the sense of, so your sarvanasham is happening. It should not be like that. Something you should keep for yourself. That being said, there are some yagas in which sarvasva danam is given. So there is famously Vishwajit yaga is there. So Nachiketa's father was performing Vishwajit yaga. So in the Vishwajit yaga, the danam, prescribed danam is sarvasva danam. Everything you should give away. The idea is later he will earn it anyway. Anyway, so that anashakena is important. That is what Shukracharya also is telling in that Shukra Niti. So what is he telling? Famous shloka from Bhagavatam. Dharmaya yashaseerthaya atmane swajanaya cha panchadha vibhajan vittam ihamutra cha shobhate is what Tilakakara is writing. I have checked Bhagavatam there. Modate is the patha. Be that as it may. Ityuktaritya tad vibhajanajnyaha. So artha vibhagavit means he who knows how to divide wealth. How to divide means how to divide and spend. This you should take in the sense of generally when Rama is leading a life in the palace, he knows whatever income he is getting, he knows how to divide it and how to make proper use of each of those divisions. So that Smriti, which is Bhagavatam here, is saying you have to divide it into five parts. And then each part, it's mentioning some purpose. When Rama is going to forest completely for 14 years, Sarvasvam he gives away. We will see all that later. So when otherwise, generally when he is leading a life in the palace, he knows how to divide his wealth and how to spend. And how to divide that? So Bhagavatam is telling dharmaya. So 120% you should spend on dharma, dharmaya. And then yashase, 20% for yashas, that is to generate fame. So some PR, you know, public relations. So some ad. So a Raja needs those things. Even today we see government spends in ads, etc. Something like that. So yashase. And then arthaya. This arthaya is very important. I understand arthaya means for further saving. So 20% you keep for savings. Arthaya means to earn further wealth. From this wealth you should earn further wealth. How will you do? Some kind of savings. And then atmane, for your own sake you spend another 20%. And swajanaya, swajanaya means for your dependents, for their sake you spend 20%. So dharmaya yashase arthaya atmane swajanaya cha panchadha vibhajan vittam. So vittam panchadha vibhajan, having divided vitta here, you should take as wealth or income, having divided that into five parts. Ihamutra cha shobhate. So this person becomes happy. Modate is Bhagavata's patha. So he can lead a happy life, having divided his income into five parts and spending appropriately. That's the idea. So Rama knows this smriti. Obviously you should not say during Rama's time Bhagavatam was not there. So obviously it's not that Rama studied Bhagavatam and knew it. But then in Bhagavatam itself, it's mentioned from the popular parlance at that time. You should take that way. Story wise, Vamanavatara story precedes Rama, you know. So even though Bhagavatam was not written, but Rama must be knowing those stories. And anyway, these dharmas must be in popular parlance anyway. And then, so artha vibhagavit means that Rama knows how to spend wealth, so how to spend his income. So 20% some assignments are given for this 20, this is what you should do. With another 20%, this is a general rule. Obviously specific exceptions are there in the Vedas when they speak about sarvasva danam, etc. So this Shukracharya quotes to Bali and he says you should follow this, and better not. It's okay to, and then when it comes to your life, this is all Shukra Niti. Don't take it to be real Niti. So if you see Mahabharatam, it will tell you otherwise. So Mahabharatam will tell you, even if it comes to the question of your life, you should not give away on dharma. So because dharma is more eternal, life is obviously impermanent. So for holding on to something impermanent, you should not give away. I will read that. So holding on to something impermanent, you should not give away something that is more eternal. That is what Mahabharata says. Shukraniti says that it's okay. In the case of prana sankatam, etc., you can kind of transgress dharma, take back your word, because he is going to put an end to you. Of course, Vishnu doesn't put an end to Bali, because Bali is considered to be a great bhakta. He is Prahlada's grandson, so that kind of special favor also Vishnu kind of provides to him. All that is there. So this is coming from Vidura Niti. Dharmaya yashasethaya atmane svajanaya cha panchadha vibhajanvittam ha mutra cha shobhate. So if you are interested, the reference to this shloka is Bhagavatam 8.19.37. Ashtama Skandha 19th Adhyaya 37th shloka. There are some 10-15 shlokas like that. It is famous as Vidura Niti. Shukra Niti, that is famous as Shukra Niti. So Shukracharya instructs to Bali at what all places you can kind of transgress dharma. Such is the theme of that Niti there. So Rama knows this Artha Vibhagavit, means he knows in general how to divide his will. Arohe Vinaye Chaiva Yuktaha. So Vinayaha means Vividha Gati Anayanam Shikshanamba. So this Vinaya Aroha means climbing. But Vinaya, he is giving different meanings. Tilakakara, Vinaya means Vividha Gati Anayanam Shikshanamba. Shikshanam means taming the elephant, the rogue elephant or something. Taming it is called Shikshanam. And then Vividha Gati Anayanam means, so kind of nicely riding it. So how to, sometimes, you know, you can perhaps ride in different ways the elephant. So those things, so Rama knows very well. So that is one thing. Interestingly, I was reading something. Okay, let me not go into that. Now, Arohe Vinaye, what Shiromanikara is telling, Artha Vibhagavit means Arthanam Dhanadinam Vibhagam Shastrokta Vibhajanam Vetti Saha. That is the meaning he is giving for that word. Of course, he is also quoting that Bhagavatam Shlokam. So, Artha Vibhagavit means Arthanam Vibhagam Vetti Iti Artha Vibhagavit. Now, what is Arthanam means what? Dhanadinam. And Vibhagam means Shastrokta Vibhajanam. Veti means he who knows. So Arthanam is equal to Dhanadinam, comma, Vibhagam is equal to Shastrokta Vibhajanam. Veti saha Artha Vibhagavit. Arthanam Vibhagam Veti iti Artha Vibhagavit. Arohe. Varanavajinam Arohe. Arohe means Arohane. That is to climb on that. Vinaye. Shikshane cha. Vinaya means Shikshana. Taming cha. Yuktaha. Nipunaha. So Yuktaha means, so he is an expert, that's the idea. So Arohe Vinaye Chaiva Yuktaha means Nipunaha. And then what is it that he climbs and tames and all that? Varana Vajinam. So Varanaha means, so suppose you don't know the meaning, he is telling Varana means Gaja, Varana and Vaji. Now Govinda Raja has nothing special more to add, all that is covered in the other two Vyakhyas. Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtho Loketirathasammataha Abhiyata Praharta Cha Senanaya Visharadaha. So Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtaha. Rama is an expert amongst all those who know archery. So Dhanurveda, all those people who know. So amongst them, Rama is the expert. Shreshtaha. Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtaha. Loke Atiratha Sammataha. Now this Atiratha Sammataha can mean two things. That is all Atirathis. So Atiratha, Maharatha, Ardharatha, Ratha, like that. There are four kind of, some fourth name, something is there. So these four kind of divisions of Sena. So these Maha Atirathas, Atiratha, Maharatha. Atiratha, I think, is the highest category. So those Atirathas kind of respect Rama. So Rama is a great warrior. Like that, who's acknowledging, not you and me. Atirathas are acknowledging. So one Vidwan only knows the Parishrama of the other Vidwan. So Vidwan eva vijanati vidvajjana parishramam. So like that, there is one shloka. Only one Vidwan can recognize the other person's Vidvat. Suppose somebody like me praises somebody's Panditiyam. So it means nothing. My Panditiyam is small, so what my praise amounts to nothing to him. But then suppose a great scholar is praising somebody's Panditiyam, then that praise means something. It holds some value. So that is Atiratha Sammataha means Rama is such a great archer, warrior, that great Atirathas also acknowledge his greatness in warfare. And then Abhiyata, what is Abhiyata? परसेनाभिमुखं याता. सो अभियाता मीन्स यू नो सो टू काइंड ऑफ रामा इज नॉट समबडी हू विल फ्ली फ्रॉम बैटल फील्ड. इफ देर इज एन एनिमी इन अ वॉर, रामा इज समबडी हू गोज टुवर्ड्स हिम, दैट इज ही लीड्स द चार्ज. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अभियाता. अभियाता मीन्स अभिमुखेन याता. याता मीन्स गंता, वन हू इज गोइंग इन दैट डायरेक्शन. So he goes in the direction of the enemy. That is, he leads the charge. That is Rama. Prahartha cha. Prahartha means so one who kills. So one who puts an end to enemies. And then Senanaya Visharadaha. Rama is also expert in, military affairs, etc. So he knows those days, you know, so you have these various vyuhams, Padma vyuham and all that. If you see Mahabharata, then they will tell you each day, what is the vyuham that Pandavas have designed? What is the vyuham that the Kauravas have designed? Of course, Padmavyuha has famously known Abhimanyu story. So all that Rama knows, how to strategize the army, what location, how much to keep. You will see that in Yuddhakanda. He will divide the enemy, the army, and say, you people attack Lanka from northern direction, you people attack from southern direction. Such kind of instructions are, so those discussions are made in Yuddhakanda, we will see. So they strategize and go. So such kind of strategies Rama is very well in designing. Senanaya Visharadaha. Now what Tilakakara is telling Abhiyata, already I said, Parasenabhimukham Yata. So Parasenabhimukham. So the enemy Sena, he goes towards them. That is, he leads the charge of his Sena towards the other Sena. And then Yata. Prahartha means Shatrunam Prahartha. That is, he attacks and he kills also. Prahartha, that meaning is also there. So Prahartha can means he attacks the enemy. Shatrunam Prahartha. So you can say somebody Harta. So somebody who can Prakrishtena Harta. So he is somebody who can kill also. Sena Nayaha Chakradi Vyuhena Sena Nyasaha Tatra Visharado Nipunaha. Sena Naya Visharadaha means Sena Vyuhena. So Chakradi Vyuhena Sena Nyasaha. Tatra Visha. Sena Nyasaha means arranging the Sena in different Vyuhas. That Rama is an expert at. Dhanurveda Vidam, Dhanurvedan, Dhanuradi Swarupadi Bodhakani Shastrani Vidanti Tesha Madhye Shreshtaha. So Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtaha means, so in Dhanurveda and all some related skills will be there, you know, along with Dhanurveda. So Dhanurveda literally, of course, it means archery. But of course, sword and mace and all such things are also there. So all those things also he knows. That is the idea. And then Loke Sarva Bhavane Atiratha Sammato Atirathehi Pujitaha. That is covered. Harta Ripusena Nivartakascha Senanaya Visharadaha means Senanaya Yuharachanayam Visharadaha Nipun. Harta means Ripusena Nivartakaha, he is telling. Harta here is he can make the opposite enemy flee in fear. That is Harta. So Praharta. So pra you can use as an upasarga, that is so that is a prefix, that is prakrishtena harta, who can very nicely make the enemy camp run away in fear. That is Rama's that all we will see, all these things we will see in Yuddhakanda. Praharta ripu sena nivartakaha. And then senanaya visharadaha senanaya means vyuharachanaya visharadaha nipunah. Now so now Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtaha, Govinda Raja is pointing out, Dhanurveda is an Upaveda, that's why we are able to say Dhanurveda. So you know only four Vedas, where did this Dhanurveda come from? It is an Upaveda. So Upavedatva Dhanurvedasya Vedatvam. And then Shreshtaha means Samarma Dhanurveda Vid Ityarthaha. So Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtaha, he is an expert amongst those who know Dhanurveda. So he knows Dhanurveda means something. Dhanurveda Vidam Shreshtaha, what is that Shreshtyam or what is the Shreshtata there, that what is the greatness of Rama's knowledge in Dhanurveda? That is, he knows the nuances also of Dhanurveda. That is, how to, where to attack, where to shoot the arrow and how to shoot the arrow, all those things, and how to kind of remove the arrow also, such things he knows. If I remember rightly, Ramabana has that capacity that if it attacks a warrior, so it kills somebody and the arrow comes back to him. I think in Ravana Yuddha it is said like that. If I remember rightly, the arrow kind of pierces Ravana and then comes back. Something like that is there. So that's why even Hanuman, when he's crossing the ocean, he makes a declaration. So Gamishyami what is that? So he says, I'm going to go like Ramabana. That in Sundarakanda, in the first sarga itself, it comes, that shloka, that I am going to go like Ramabana. I'm not able to remember the shloka, it's a famous shloka. Anyway, so that is a shloka where he says, I'm going to go like Ramabana. So there people say, what is the greatness of Ramabana? Not only will he go there, he will not be trapped there. Like Rama's Astra goes, the arrow goes, pierces the target and comes back. Hanuman also is saying, I will go to Lanka, do my job and come back. That is the idea. Yatha Raghava Nirmukta Sharas Shwasana Vikramaha. That's the second pada, something is there. Yatha Raghava Nirmuktaha Sharaha Shwasana Vikramaha. So that Raghava Nirmukta Sharaha, the Shara that Raghava Rama releases, Shwasana Vikramaha. Shwasana Vikramaha means it goes in the speed of wind. So like that, I will come back. So I will go there and come back. Ardhayitva Purim Lankam Abhivadya Cha Maithilim Samruddhartho Gamishyami. So like that shloka goes, so further shlokas. So I will go to Lanka, Ardhayitva Purim Lankam. I'm going to trouble those people. Abhivadya Cha Maithilim. I will do my Abhivadanam Namaskara to Maithili. I will meet her, Janaki Devi, I will meet. And then Samruddhartha Gamishyami. So I will complete my task and come back. So that's the idea. So Rama's Shreshthata there, I'm trying to point out. So he knows the nuances of also of Dhanurveda. He has learned already so much from Vishwamitra. So that is Shreshthaha means Samarma Dhanurvedavid Ityarthaha. Now Loke Atiratha Sammataha. This Loke word I forgot to explain. Loke means in this world, Sarvatra. Loke, Shiromanikara wrote Sarva Bhavane. Maybe it is Sarva Bhuvane. It could be a print mistake. I'm correcting in my copy. Maybe it is Sarva Bhuvane. So Loke Sarvatra Atirathanam Apratihata Ratha Gatinam Sammataha Pujitaha. So he's somebody who is well acknowledged. Atirata Sammataha means, so he's well acknowledged by even Atirathas in this world. Loke means in this world means what? Everywhere, in all kingdoms, amongst all archers. So Rama is well acknowledged by Atirathas as a great warrior. Sammataha means very well acknowledged. What is this Atiratha? Atiratha means apratihata ratha gati naam. Atirathas are those people whose ratha has no, so if this Atiratha is going, there is nobody who can put an end to that Atiratha's gati. That if he starts attacking people, then people will only die. Nobody can kill him. He's like that. That is an equal Atiratha can obviously attack him. That is there. So Atiratha means apratihata ratha gatinam. This is the first time I'm seeing this meaning. It's a beautiful meaning. Atirathas means whose ratha gati has no stoppage. It can all that rampage will continue once they start killing. Now, Govinda Raja has some things to say here. Let me read. Abhiyata Shatru Samagamananantaram na prahartum ichchati kintu swayameva yatra shatravaha tatra gachati tatrapi. So abhiyata means shatru samagamanantaram na pratihartum ichchati. So abhiyata means kintu swayameva yatra shatravaha tatra gachati. That is Rama abhiyata means he takes the lead. So takes the lead, abhiyata means he takes the charge, he does, you know. So abhiyata, Shiromani, Bhushanakara, Govinda Raja is telling, Rama is not such kind of a warrior that he will wait, let all those people assemble, let they come to my place, then I will kill them. No, he will go to their place, he will go to the enemy's camp and then he will kill. Like he did in Ravana's case, you know, he goes to Lanka, to go to Lanka itself, so many problems, he has to build that Varathi, etc., that Setu he had to build. Still he does all that, he will go to the enemy camp and kill him there. That is the meaning of Abhiyata he is telling. Abhiyata, Shatru Samagamananantaram na Pratihartum Ichchati, Kintu Swayameva Yatra Shatravaha Tatra Gachati, and Tatrapi na Durga Pradeshavalambanena Yati, Kintu Abhiyata, Abhimukham Yata Praha. So there also, so he goes to their place and then he will not hide in with the cover of, that Durga means fort. So he will not take shelter of fort, etc., and then kill them. So he will lead the charge. Like I said, when the army is coming, he goes head on into the battle and fights the war. He is such kind of a warrior. And then Praharta means Abhigamya. Prahartacha Abhigamya na Yodhair Yadhayati. योधैर् योधयति किन्तु स्वयमेव नासीरे स्थित्वा प्रथमं प्रहरति सो दट प्रहर्ता अभि सो अभियाता प्रहर्ता च इज देयर सो ही समबडी हु गोज हेड ऑन एंड देन प्रहर्ता इज व्हाट डिड ही से प्रहरति स्वयमेव नासीरे स्थित्वा प्रथमं प्रहरति दट इज ही इज द फर्स्ट वन टू टेक द अटैक आल्सो रामा नॉट ओनली इज द फर्स्ट पर्सन टू स्पीक नॉट ओनली पूर्वभाषी बट प्रहर्ता आल्सो दट इज द आइडिया सो रामा इन अ कॉन्वर्जेशन ही विल बी द फर्स्ट वन टू इनिशिएट अ कॉन्वर्जेशन He will be the first one to release the arrow. Even before you can think what you can do, Rama Bana will come and kill you. That's the idea. So, Prahartacha, then, Prathamam, Senanaya Visharadaha, Swayam Praharannapi, Naswa Senam Chedayati, Kintu Para Duravagaha Chakravyuhadi Bhagena, Sena Prapana Samarthaha. So, very nicely he is writing, the Senanaya Visharadaha, you should take these three words together, Abhiyata, Praharta, Senanaya Visharadaha. So Rama goes to that place and then he doesn't take cover of bushes, forts, etc. He will lead head on, but as even he is leading head on, he is also conscious of his soldiers. So how to form the soldier, the military formation, etc. So that his soldiers also don't lose out in the war. That is, they don't get killed, etc. So minimal damage to his side, maximum damage to the other side. Such kind of Vyuha Rachana also he can do. As even he is attacking, he also kind of like, my knowledge of cricket is 0 or 1 out of 100. But then something like a captain as even, or a bowler, as even he is trying to discharge the ball, he kind of sets the field, you know. Rama is like that. As even he is fighting the war, he sets the army formation, etc. Now, so Sena, so Naswa Senam Chedayati Kintu Para Duravagaha Chakravyuhadi Vibhagena. He doesn't let his Sena die. That is the idea. He forms a nice military formation so that his Senas are also strong enough. Now, Apradharsha, so there is lot more. Let me just read one or two lines. Apradharshyascha, so Pradharshayitum Ashakyaha. So he goes into the next shloka also. According to Govinda Raja, the next half also has to be added to the shloka. अप्रधृष्यश्च संग्रामे क्रुद्धैरपि सुरासुरैः अनसुयोजित क्रोधो न दृप्तो न च मत्सरी सो दिस अप्रधृष्यः ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग अप्रधृष्यश्च मीन्स प्रदर्शयितुम अशक्यः सर्वता विजयीत्यर्थः दैट इज ही इज एन इनविंसिबल पर्सन दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अप्रधृष्यः यू कैन नॉट डिफीट हिम ही इज द वन हु ऑलवेज विन सर्वता विजयी संग्रामे सो संग्रामे अप्रधृष्यः प्रणत्यादु जेतुम शक्यः इत्यर्थः So, apradrishyascha sangrame. So, the idea is, in a sangrama, in a war, he is invincible. But when you do bhakti, very nicely, he will come and kind of come in your control, like that, something like that. So, in a war, you cannot defeat him, but with bhakti, you can win his heart. You can kind of defeat him. Defeat him means you can win his heart. That's the idea. So, pradharshaitum ashakyaha sarvatha vijayati tirthaha sangrame vijayati sarvatha Pranatyatu jetum shakyaha, with pranati, that is with bhakti, you can win over him. Na kevalam manushyaihi, surasuraihi, paraspara virodham vihaya militairapicha upashantaihi, kruthaihi, krodha paravashaihi, surasuraihi, apradharishyaihi, sangrame. That is, apradharishyascha sangrame, kruthairapi surasuraihi. So, surasurairapi apradharishyaha, when he is telling, Rama is invincible, not just by Suras separately or Asuras separately, but even assume that for a moment Suras and Asuras have forgotten their enmity and come together. Even if Suras and Asuras for a moment have come together and fight against Rama, still they cannot defeat him. He is so invincible that even if in that hypothetical scenario where these people come together, Suras and Asuras, even if they come together, they cannot kill him. That is the idea. So, na chopashantaihi krudhaihi krodha paravashaihi. And then, surasuraihi, not peaceful surasuraihi. They are extremely wrathful, let's say. Extremely ferocious, they are angry, such kind of. So, the idea is sometimes when you get extremely angry, you get some boosts of power. You don't know from where you get, but you get that power. So, not only just by suras and asuras separately, but both of them, even hypothetically, if they get together. And then they also get together, not in a friendly way. They get together and extremely enraged. At that way also, if they fight with Rama, they cannot defeat him. That's the idea. Apradhrishyascha sangrame kruddhairapi surasuraihi. That I have to explain to you. So, about Tilakagara, etc., are saying to this. So, Matsaraha, so Anasuyaha, Jitakrodhaha, Nadruptaha, Nacha Matsari is there. So, Tilakagara is just explaining that word here. Matsara means Parasampadveshaha. So, Rama is not envious about another person's wealth. That is Matsara. Matsaryam is envy about another person's wealth. Rama is Nacha Matsari. He doesn't have that Matsari. Shiromani Kara Anasuyaha. So, Anasuyakaha, earlier he explained it in different way. Again, I think the word came. Now, again, he is explaining Anasuyaha Sarva Vishayaka Asuya Rahitaha. So, here simply he is telling he has no kind of that perception of a lack, out of that perception of a lack, you kind of get a jealousy when you see another thing that you don't have. So that kind of, that towards that person, you will have some jealousy, that asuya, that sarva vishayaka asuya rahitaha. Rama has no envy with regards to anything in this world. That is the idea. So now jitakrodhaha already has come earlier, I think, as something. So now he see how he is explaining jitakrodhaha. So anasuyo jitakrodhaha, there Shiromanikara is putting an avagraha. So it becomes anasuyaha ajitakrodhaha. Now what is ajitakrodhaha? Jitakrodhaha means somebody who has won over anger. Ajitakrodhaha, if you say somebody who has not won over anger, so that does not become a suguna. Now, but then ajitakrodhaha, he is explaining it differently. Ajitakrodhaha, this is Shiromanikara's patha. So it is jitakrodhaha only, but he has taken it as Anasuyaha Ajitakrodhaha. Where did that A come? So because of that Sandhi O is there, you know, you can imagine an Avagraha there. Anasuyo Jitakrodhaha. Anasuyaha Ajitakrodhaha. Now Ajitakraha. Ajitakraha and Dhaha. That is the idea. Ajitakrodhaha. Ajitakraha and Dhaha. These kind of meanings he is an expert at giving. So Ajitakraha means Ajitaha Parabhavitum Ashakyaha Kraha Kritihi Yasya Saha. Ajitakraha means Rama's kriti. Kriti here is, you can take as his acts. His acts are such that they cannot be defeated. That is, Rama is so fierce a warrior that he cannot be defeated. That's the idea of ajitakraha. Now tatra hetuhu adhaha. Now ajitakrodhaha, also there ajitakraha adhaha again. So there two akaras he is assuming. So anasuyo jitakrodho krodhaha means there jitakraha adhaha. What is adhaha? So tatra hetuhu adhaha nadho dhata yasya saha swasattashritaha ityartaha. Very nicely. So whether you like such kind of meanings, I don't know, but since he is giving, I'm telling you, and very nicely also he is telling. So Rama is ajitakraha, one whose tasks cannot be undone. So why is it that his tasks cannot be undone or kind of overruled? So Rama's task cannot be, Rama's decision cannot be overruled. You take it that way. Kriti here, take it as decision. So Rama's decision cannot be overruled. Why? Because he is adhaha. Adhaha means navidyate dhata yasya. There is no boss to Rama. That is the idea. So Rama's acts cannot be overruled. That is ajitakraha. Because he is adhaha. He does not have a boss. So anasuyaha, one who does not have asuya. And ajitakraha, one whose acts cannot be overruled. Why? Because adhaha. Adhaha means he does not have any boss over him. Na vidyate, so nadho dhata yasya. Nadhaha iti adhaha. What is this? Nadhaha, nadhata. So na vidyate dhata yasya. Saha adhaha. He does not have a boss. So whom is he? If you have a boss, so if you have a swami, then you depend on him. So Vishwam Pashyati. So what is that? Vishwam Pashyati Karya Karanataya Swaswami Sambandhataha. So you are Swa and you have Swami. You are one person, you have a Lord over you. So Rama is somebody who does not have a Lord over him. If there is a Lord over you, then you are sustained by him. So who is sustaining Rama then? If he does not have a boss over him, who is sustaining him? He is Swasattashritaha. He depends on himself. So that is Swayam Prakasha, etc. Such kind of meanings you can bring in here. So Sattashritaha, Rama depends on itself. So I think Sri Ramakrishna used to say this. Swamiji says this also. So a bird is sitting, or maybe some other Mahatma would have said, but Swamiji says this. A bird is sitting on a thing. Now suppose you fell the branch, you cut the branch. The bird fall down, do not fall down. it will still fly. The bird is sitting on itself. That is, the bird is not depending on the branch. The bird on itself. Therefore, even if that ashraya, which is the branch on which the bird is sitting, even if the ashraya is lost, the bird is not lost. That means that is not the ashraya. That is the idea. Because otherwise, if something is the ashraya, if the ashraya goes, then the ashrita also has to go. So if the ashrita is not going when the ashraya is going, that means that is not the ashraya. This is not the ashrita. Like that, Rama is swasattashritaha. He depends on himself. Therefore, there is no lord for him. Therefore, there is nobody who can overrule his kind of acts. So ajitakraha adhaha na druptaha. Dripta means garva. So na driptaha means na garvavan. That is, he doesn't have arrogance. So that is I think it's called spite in English. So he doesn't have any arrogance. Na matsari, so dveshavan na. So he doesn't have dvesha also. So anasuya you can take as envy, and then matsaryam here you can take as dvesha. He doesn't have dvesha towards a person just because he happens to have something he doesn't have. So just in, I don't have Dhammapada book today, just in evening class today, so santushtihi paramam dhanam, that is one word in Buddha's arogyam paramo labha. So arogyam is the greatest labha, and paramam dhanam, that is shloka. Santushti is the greatest dhanam. Okay, so santushti is the greatest dhanam. Why? So this person who has santushti, he has everything. So suppose you live in a, let's say, one bedroom house, kitchen house, then you are extremely contented. Somebody comes and tells you, you know, there is a three bedroom house, so you say, yeah, I have that three bedroom house. So that person will say, how come you don't have that money to buy that three bedroom house? How can you say I have it? No, I have the money with which I can buy. I have that three bedroom house already, and I have the money which has bought that three bedroom house already. That money is santushti. Santushti is contentment. So because I have contentment, that is the greatest dhanam. That is the greatest dhanam means what? If you have santushti, everything is as though already obtained. Santushti is that money which can make everything already obtained. I am not interested in it. How are you able to say? Because the santushti has bought it already for you. That contentment has already bought those things for you. Anyway, so Rama is like that. Na matsari, here is na dveshavan. I don't know whether you found it related to the context or not. I said something. Now, Govinda Raja, so he's covered the shloka already. This second half he has to talk about. एवं कल्याण गुण परिपूरत्वं परिपूर्णत्वं उक्तं अथ हेय प्रत्यनीकत्वं आह. सो नाउ अनसूयः जितक्रोधः व्हेन ही इज टेलिंग श्रोमणी कारास काइंड ऑफ बिल्डिंग अप अ संबंध टू दैट एंड दिस. सो 29 एंड अ हाफ श्लोकास हैव सेड दैट रामा हैज ऑल ऑस्पिशियस क्वालिटीज. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस सेकंड हाफ ऑफ 30th श्लोका, what Valmiki is telling, that he doesn't have any inauspicious qualities. That is what he is telling. Therefore, anasuyaha jitakrodhaha, etc. Jitakrodhaha means krodha paravashya rahitaha. He is writing nicely. Jitakrodhaha means one who has conquered anger. But what does it mean? So, krodha paravashya rahitaha. He doesn't succumb to anger. So, anger we have won over means what? In a situation, when anger dictates something, you will say, no, I am not going to listen to you. Hey anger, hey manyu. I am not going to listen to you. I am not going to do as you are dictating to me. That is the idea of jita krodhaha, which he very nicely says. Jita krodhaha means krodha paravashya rahitaha. Anasuyo jita krodhaha na driptaha ata matsari. That also we have seen. Now, this, I think it goes with the next shloka, what he is writing. Navagneyascha bhutanam nacha kala vashanugaha. एवं श्रेष्ठैर गुणैर युक्तः प्रजानां पार्थिवात्मजः. सो न अवज्ञेयः. सो अवज्ञेयः मीन्स व्हाट? सो न अवज्ञेयः, लेट्स सी व्हेन वी गो टू दैट कमेंट्री, दे विल से समथिंग. सो न अवज्ञेयः इज, आई थिंक व्हाट इट मीन्स इज, ही इज नॉट, सो ही इज ऑलवेज रेस्पेक्टेड, ही इज नॉट स्लाइटेड बाय एनीथिंग. आई थिंक दैट्स द मीनिंग. न अवज्ञेयः भूतानां, सो भूतानां न अवज्ञेयः. सो then na cha kala vashanugaha, so he is not under the pangs of time. That is, he is not under the control of time. Time is so powerful, that it has everybody, it holds everybody by its by their tufts. So pangs hold, so time holds us by our shikha, that's the idea. So by our hair, you can say these days we are not sporting a shikha. So by our hair, it's already holding. Everybody is in the control of time, but not Rama. Acha kalavashangaha. Evam shreshtha gunair yuktaha prajanam parthivatmajaha sammatas trishu lokeshu vasudhayaha kshamagunaihi buddhya brihaspate stulyaha vidye chapi shachipatehe etc. Again, some gunas are coming. So, evam shreshtha gunair yuktaha prajanam parthivatmajaha. That itself you can take as one sentence ending there. That evam shreshtha gunair yuktaha, that Rama who is endowed with such shreshtha gunas, evam shreshtha gunair yuktaha means in thusly endowed with shreshtha gunas, that Rama prajanam parthivatmajaha asti. You can say like that, this Rama who is endowed with such great noble qualities, prajanam partho, prajanam has to go with some other shloka, and then parthivatmajaha, that is he is the son of that prince. We will see that Anvaya will get settled if you see the next shlokas. Now let's see what he is telling. Acha kalavashanukaha, Govinda Raja is completing there. Sattvarajas tama pradhana kala anuguna sattvarajas tamo guno nabhavati kevala sattvamurtihi tyartha. So he is giving a technical meaning. Acha kalavashanukaha, that is, so sometimes in our life, so we are all made of these three gunas, sattvarajas and tamo gunas. Sometimes sattva guna will dominate in us, sometimes rajo guna will dominate, sometimes tamo guna will dominate. So extreme activity when you are involved in, it is rajo guna. So mental activity or even physical activity. Sattva guna is you are more calm. So you are knowing things, but then you are calm. And tamo guna is you are lazy. Let's say you are sleeping. That's a typical example that they give for tamo guna. You are lazy and sleeping, that is tamo guna. But Rama is not like that. Rama doesn't give in to gunas, the guna swings, you can say, like mood swings. Rama doesn't give in to guna swings. Rama is always Shuddha Sattva. That is, for them, Rama is Paramatma. And then Paramatma is, you know, when you say Paramatma is Nirguna, Vishishtadvaitin say, what it means is these Heya gunas are not there. These kind of improper gunas are not there in him. Rajo guna, tamo guna is not there in Paramatma. Only he is Shuddha Sattva Swabhava, like that they say. So Rama is like that. Acha Kala Vashanugaha means he is kevala sattva murtihi. He is filled with sattva guna. That is the idea he is saying. Tilakakara here, so prajanam means siddhanam, another patha is there, he is telling. No, that is katakakara's patha. Now kalavashaha means kalaparatantriyam prakritavat tadanusari na swayatta sarva parikaraha iti yavat. Na kalavashanugaha means, so he is not a slave to time. What does that slave to time means? Na kala paratantriyam, what is that? Prakritavat tad anusari. So we follow time. Rama is not like that. Rama doesn't follow time. Time follows Rama. Something like that is the meaning. Na swayatta sarva parikaraha iti avat. So swayatta sarva parikaraha, let me use kalavashaha, kala paratantriyam, prakritavat tad anusari na swayatta parikara sarva parikaraha. So swayatta sarva parikaraha, sarva parikaraha means all his, you know, his let's say his senses and all those things. Parikara also means parijanas there, so all of them are under his control. He is not under anybody's control. Maybe that is what he is trying to say. Now parthivatmajaha ramaha kshama gunaihi vasudhayaha tulyaha, that is all later. No navagneha, these people have not written anything. Navagneha. So what is the translation for Navagneha? He has written somewhere. Navagneha. Okay. So what is the translation written in your books? Maybe you can tell me. Navagneha. Already Shantaram Garu has typed something. So it was me. Yeah, I told that meaning, humiliated. Okay, so navagneha means that, so bhutanam navagneha, so he is not kind of slighted by anybody. That's the idea, bhutanam navagneha. Now Chiromanikara has some things to say. Parthivatmajaha ramaha, that is all that, so evam shreshtha gunair yuktaha, all that other two shlokas also let us read, 32 and 33. So navagneyascha bhutanam nacha kala vashanugaha evam shreshtha gunair yuktaha. नाच अवमंता. सो आई रिमेंबर समथिंग दे हैव रिटन, वी विल सी इन द कॉमेंट्री वॉट दे आर सेइंग. ना अवमंता ऑल्सो द सेम थिंग. सो सो ही इज अवमंता देयर वुड मीन दैट ही डजंट स्लाइट एनी वन इन दैट सेंस मे बी. आई रिमेंबर सम सच मीनिंग्स एंड ऑल्टरनेट रीडिंग्स हियर इफ आई रिमेंबर. लेट्स सी इफ आई कम अक्रॉस द कॉम इन द कॉमेंट्री. पार्थिवात्मज राम क्षमा गुण वसुधाया तुल. ओ आई हैव टू रीड द श्लोकास. नावज्ञेयश्च भूतानां न च कालवशानुगः एवं श्रेष्ठगुणैर्युक्तः प्रजानां पार्थिवात्मजः सम्मतस्त्रिषु लोकेषु वसुधायाः क्षमागुणैः बुद्ध्या बृहस्पतेस्तुल्यो वीर्ये चापि शचीपतेः तथा सर्वप्रजाकान्तैः प्रीतिसञ्जननैः पितुः गुणैरिव गुणैर्विरुचे रामो दीप्तसूर्य इवांशुभिः. सो पार्थिवात्मज मीन्स राम द सन ऑफ अ किंग दट इज दिस प्रिंस राम पार्थिवात्मज क्षमा गुण वसुधाया तुल्य. सो इन क्षमा गुण दट इज इन टर्म्स ऑफ फोर बेरेन्स हीज टू बी कंपेर्ड विथ वसुधा विथ अर्थ. सो भूमा देवी सपोज टू हैव द ग्रेटेस्ट क्षमा दट इज वी आर किकिंग हर एंड देन वी आर वॉकिंग ऑन हर एंड डूइंग ऑल सॉर्ट्स ऑफ थिंग्स. सो वी आर मोर ऑफ अ बर्डन टू हर बट शी डजेंट थिंक लाइक दैट. सो शी इज लाइक अ मदर भूमा. So that वसुधायाः क्षमागुणैः क्षमागुणैः वसुधायाः तुल्यः. इन हिज फॉरबेरेंस इन हिज क्षमागुण ही इज टू बी कंपेर्ड विद वसुधा भूमि. एंड देन बुद्ध्या बृहस्पतेस्तुल्यः दट ऑल्सो इज कमिंग इन 32nd श्लोक. इन हिज बुद्धि इन हिज इंटेलिजेंस ही इज इक्वेटेड टू बृहस्पति. बुद्ध्या बृहस्पतेस्तुल्यः वीर्ये शचीपतेस्तुल्यः. इन हिज वैलर ही इज टू बी इक्वेटेड विद शचीपति दट इज इंद्र. अतएव भूतानां सी ही इज कमिंग हियर. अतएव भूतानां अवज्ञेयः अनादरणीयः न दट इज बिकॉज ही इज सो ग्रेट. सो दट इज ही इज इक्वल टू इन क्षमा गुण इन इंटेलिजेंस एंड इन पवर ही इज सो ग्रेट. देयरफॉर ही इज नॉट स्लाइटेड बाय एनीबडी. अतएव भूतानां अवज्ञेयः अनादरणीयो न न कालवशा अनुगा अनुचरा. ओ न कालवशानुगः दट इज वॉट तिलककार सेड यू नो. So Rama is not under na kala vasha anugaha can mean two ways. Kala vasha anugaha na, that is Rama doesn't come under the grip of time, that is one meaning. Or the other meaning which Tilakakara also said there is, so Rama's anugas, that is the followers of Rama, don't come under the trap of time. That's the idea. So na swayatta sarva parikaraha iti. So all Rama's, I think that's what he's trying to say, Rama's followers don't come under the control of time. That's what Shiromani Kara also is telling. Kalavasha anuga anuchara yasya sa na. That is, Rama doesn't have any followers, means people who have taken shelter under him. Rama doesn't have anyone who has taken shelter under him who fall under the clasp of time. So this is so in Sanskrit it's easily to explain, but in English, let me say, because the other day Vedanta Paribhasha also was trying to explain this sentence, similar sentence. So Rama does not have anybody, any ashrita. Rama does not have any ashrita who comes under the clasp of time. Means what? It does not mean Rama does not have any ashrita. That does not, you should put with clasp of time. You should connect it that way. Rama's ashritas never come under the clasp of time. That is a clasp or grip. I don't know clasp is the right word or not. So Rama's followers or ashrita, people who have taken shelter under Rama, they don't come under the grip of time. That is the idea, meaning of kala. Na kala vashanugaha. Rama's anugas don't come under the grip of time. In Yuddhakanda, you will see all Vanara Senas. So even if they are dead, they will come back to life. So Ravana will lose his army. Vanaras will come back to life, be that as it may. So that is naka. So another meaning is na kaladhina anucharavan ityarthaha. That is, Rama doesn't act in the grip of time. Rama is independent. That is the idea. एवम् अनेन प्रकारेण श्रेष्ठैः गुणैः युक्तः अतैव त्रिषु ऊर्ध्वोधम मध्यवर्तिषु लोकेषु विद्यमानानां प्रजानां सम्मतः इष्टः आसीत् इति श्रेष्ठः इति शेषः. सो सम्मतस्त्रिषु लोकेषु. सो रामः त्रिषु लोकेषु सम्मतः आसीत्. दट् आसीत् यू हेव् टु एड्. सो त्रिषु लोकेषु सम्मतः मीन्स् वाट्? ही इस् सम्बडी हू इस् वेल् अक्नालेज्ड् इन् आल् द त्री वर्ल्ड्स्. त्री वर्ल्ड्स् मीन्स् वाट्? सो ऊर्ध्व अधो मध्यवर्तिषु लोकेषु. देयर इज वन ऊर्ध्व लोका, देन देयर इज अधो लोका, सो वन लोका ऑन टॉप ऑफ यू, वन लोका बिलो यू, एंड यू आर इन दिस मध्य लोका. सो इन ऑल द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स रामा इज वेल अक्नॉलेज्ड. सो सम्मतः त्रिषु लोकेषु रामः सम्मतः आसीत्. एंड देन लोकेषु विद्यमानानां प्रजानां सम्मतः. सो इन द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स ही इज वेल अक्नॉलेज्ड मीन्स व्हाट? The citizens of those three worlds, the residents of those three worlds, well acknowledge Rama's greatness. Kincha virye samadhika rahita parakrame vidyamano Ramaha kshamagunaihi trushulokeshu vidyamanayaha vasudhayaha sammataha puritaha ataeva brahaspatehe shachipatescha buddhya atulyaha tolaitum ashakya. Atulyaha means somebody who cannot match, that is tolaitum ashakyaha. You cannot, that is Atulya highs. If you take that balance, if you put Rama here, in no quality can you put somebody equal to Rama on the other scale, you know, in that scale. Now, he is giving another meaning. Virye samadhika rahita parakrame vidyamano Ramaha kshamagunaihi trishulokeshu vidyamanayaha vasudhayaha sammataha. That is, by his, by people, so ultimately it's the same meaning, by residents of all the three worlds. So, he is unmatched in his Kshamaguna. Who is unmatched in Kshamaguna? Rama, who is who's such a great parakrami, that Rama. So that Virye Chapi Shachi Patehe, when you are telling that great Viryavan Rama is matchless in his Kshamaguna also. That is the idea. I am perhaps boring all of you, but let's just finish this. Shreshthaihi. So far have we covered everything? So Shreshthaihi Gunaihi Yuktaha. सो श्रेष्ठैहि लोकोत्तर गुणैः युक्तः गोविंद राजा स्टेलिंग श्रेष्ठ गुणास मीन्स व्हाट? लोकोत्तर गुणास. सो फार ऑल लौकिक गुणास हैव बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड परहैप्स, नाउ लोकोत्तर गुणास, गुणास दैट यू डू नॉट इवन फाइंड अमंग्स मियर मॉर्टल, सच गुणास आल्सो रामा हैज इन हिम. एवं श्रेष्ठ गुणैः युक्तः रामः सो प्रजानां सम्मतः, दैट इज द आइडिया. सो त्रिषु लोकेषु प्रजानां सम्मतः, दैट इज द अन्वया विद प्रजानां. त्रिषु लोकेषु प्रजानां सम्मतः आसीत् रामः. देन क्षमारूपगुणैः बहुवचनं प्रकारभेदाभिप्रायेण. सो व्हाट इज ही टेलिंग? क्षमागुणैः. सो दट गुणैः इज बहुवचनं देयर. सो क्षमागुणैः वसुधायाः तुल्यः. सो व्हाट इज दट गुणैः? वाई बहुवचनं? बिकॉज ऑल सिमिलर गुणास ऑल्सो क्षमा, and then along with kshama some other gunas you can bring in. So he is forbearing, he doesn't complain also. So sahanam apratikara purvakam sahanam also you should have. Chinta vilapa rahitam, it should be such ancillary. He is not complaining. So some people assume they are forbear because out of helplessness. That how do you know they are forbearing out of helplessness? Because they always keep complaining. So that kind of forbearing out of helplessness is not there. He doesn't complain. All such ancillary gunas you can include in kshama gunaihi in the plural. So kshama gunaihi vasudhayaha tulyaha, when you are telling kshama and all the ancillary gunas. Now evam dvivaram gunashreshthyam upapadya punaha atidardhyaya tadupapadayati shreshtha gunaihi. Now shreshtha gunaihi, already it has been said twice before this. So shreshtha gunas we have seen. So earlier also the Shrestha has come, even in today's class, Shrestham Chastra Samu, the previous class, Shrestham Chastra Astra Samuheshu, Shrestha, Loke Abhirata Sammataha, Dhanur Veda Vidam Shrestha, and then Shrestha Gunair Yuktaha also it has come earlier. So twice Shrestha Gunair Yuktaha has been said, and then now again he is telling to kind of reinforce again and again, if Maharshi say, that shows that Rama's gunas are really Shrestha. So Dvivaram Gunashraishtyam Upapadya Punaha Atidardhyaya Tadupapadayati Sammataha Iti. So he is well acknowledged that he has all those great, great qualities. Now, Tatha Sarva Praja Kantaihi. Maybe this 33rd shloka we will see later. 31 and 32 we have seen. We will stop with this here. Navad Neyascha Bhutanam Nacha Kala Vashanugaha Evam Shrestha Gunairyuktaha Prajanam Parthivatmajaha सम्मतस्त्रिषु लोकेषु वसुधायाः क्षमागुणैः बुद्ध्या बृहस्पतेस्तुल्यो वीर्ये चापि शचीपतेः. ऐ होप् आल् द वर्ड्स् आर् क्लियर्. न अवज्ञेयः भूतानां न अवज्ञेयः न च कालवशानुगः. एण्ड् देन् एवं श्रेष्ठगुणैर्युक्तः पार्थिवात्मजः रामः त्रिषु लोकेषु प्रजानां सम्मतः
एंड देन क्षमागुण वसुधाया तुल्य बुद्धिया बृहस्पते तुल्य वीर्या वीर्ये सो वीर्ये शचीपते अपि तुल्यः दैट इज द अन्वया फॉर ऑल दीज थिंग्स नावज्ञेयश्च भूतानां न च कालवशानुगः एवं श्रेष्ठैर्गुणैर् एवं श्रेष्ठगुणैर्युक्तः आई हैव बीन रीडिंग एक्चुअली इट इज एवं श्रेष्ठैर्गुणैर्युक्तः प्रजानां पार्थिवात्मजः सम्मतस्त्रिषु लोकेषु वसुधायाः क्षमागुणैः बुद्ध्या बृहस्पतेस्तुल्यः वीर्ये चापि शचीपतेः सो 33rd श्लोक एक्सेट्रा We will take up in the next class and finish this sarga. Om yatra yatra raghunatha kirtanam tatra tatra kata mastakanjalim ashtavari paripurna lochanam marutim namata rakshasantakam Om purnamadah purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vishishyate Om shanti 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 harihi om shri gurubhyo namaha harihi om ओम तत्सत श्री रामार्पणमस्तु सो इफ यू हैव एनीथिंग टू आस्क यू कैन आस्क वी विल नॉट बी हैविंग अ क्लास टुमारो सो वी विल मीट अगेन नेक्स्ट वीक विच विल बी नेक्स्ट थर्सडे विच विल बी व्हाट इज द डेट 25th ऑफ फेब्रुवरी वी विल मीट अगेन ओके टाइपिंग एनीथिंग प्रसाद जी इज टाइपिंग Nachavamanta, I have seen ValmikiRamayana.net mostly follows Govindaraja's Patha. I have seen the way he explains the words or even the way he uses the alternate readings. He follows Govindaraja's Patha. Okay, Jai Shri Ram. So you should have patience. I keep telling you, it will take time. Ayodhya Kanda will take time. You should be mentally prepared. So I'm warning. Warning means I'm telling because you might otherwise think it's going slowly or maybe it might get boring. That feeling should not come as Rama Bhaktas, which I'm hoping all of you are, which you people are, I know also. So please have patience with me. That's the idea in my prayer. Okay, we'll meet again next week. Okay.